percentage that, I mean, the statistics they gave me were not very good at all, and I know more people that have died from the, you know, from the actual chemotherapy. So I started going to a naturopath, and the tumors have actually been reduced by like 27% since.
Wait, Jeanette, something is wrong here. Breast cancer is predominantly curable.
It is.
Especially in your age.
26 years old.
Absolutely. Jeanette, you got to get yourself back. The chemo is actually kind of mild for this, too. They shrink the tumor, take the breast off, reconstruct if you want, cure. You can expect a cure, but
chemo mild for this? It's not as bad as other forms of chemo?
Yeah, it's not a horrible chemo. It certainly doesn't kill anybody.
What's a bad chemo?
You know, things for leukemias, lymphomas.
That's a tough chemo.
Multi-drug, you get very sick from it.
All right, so, Jeanette.
Yes.
And what are you doing with the naturalist? Just getting coffee enemas and rubbing a chia pet?
Jeanette.
No, there's like 16 different types of drops that I'm taking, and there's three different machines. There's a machine called a Rife machine, and that's an anagram, R-I-F-E. I don't know what it stands for, but it cured my mom's breast cancer, and so I've been using that machine.
Yeah. Work for Steve McQueen, too.
Yeah, hey, well, it sends radio waves. It doesn't hurt.
Hold on a second. We have a powwow. Drew doesn't go for this crap.
I'll go for what works, but...
It doesn't work.
But the fact is, we can cure this one. This is a curable cancer.
Well, what kind of doctor, then, would just send her packing?
Nobody. She packed herself.
Can't they stop her?
No.
Really?
Mm-mm.
But what if they say, look, we can cure this, or there's a high percentage chance we can take care of this. You go see Dr. Dim Sum with the 4-foot beard down in Chinatown. This ain't going to work.
I'm sure they told her that.
Do you think?
They did? Oh, yeah.
Do you think she has some concerns because of her previous addiction?
Well, she does about going on pain meds, but, you know.
What about related oncology?
Jeanette.
Yes.
There's like a 200 years of education in this room and one semester at LA Valley College.
You're going to speak for everyone.
I wasn't on I didn't go in on probation. I had to earn that.
Well, what you guys are saying is actually giving me the first sense of hope that I've had, because I it's not like I just went and saw one doctor and, oh, I give up. I saw an oncologist. I saw a radiologist.
But they told you to take the chemo and the radiation, get the surgeries, and you'd have like a 60% cure rate.
No, they didn't say that. They said that it's 30% and it would come back within 3 years. There's a good chance it would come back within 3 years.
30% cure?
Yeah.
Or 30% recurrence?
No, 30% cure, and they said there was like a 70-some percent chance that it would come back within 3 years.
Doesn't sound right to me.
Plus,
and they wanted to do a thing where they take out my lymph nodes, and then they were telling me the risks.
Jeanette, that is absolutely standard routine. Those are done. That procedure is done in every hospital in America, hand over fist. No one ever has any big problem with that. I mean, you can sometimes get fistulas and things, but that's a standard procedure.
All right. So, Jeanette.
Yes.
Here's the thing. You got to start seeing the man.
Go see a different doctor, you're saying.
Yeah, all this homeopathic crap is great when you're not really sick, but when you actually get something, screw
South
that.
South Park did a great episode about that.
They did?
Oh, I saw that.
Oh, she saw it.
Yeah.
Good.
Kenny or somebody gets kidney failure, and then they're like, well, we're not doctors. What are you thinking? And the kids are like, what? You led us to believe you could do something.
Well, if that's all this crap, all this, I had a coffee enema, and I don't eat meat. So it's all great when you're not really sick, when you're just, you know, 26, and you're living up in your head, and you're full of your own, you think your ass doesn't smell. And then something happens, like your appendix bursts or something. Now it's time to go see the man. You got to see the man. And let me say this. Let me explain something, too. AIDS, under control. Homeopathic or the man? The man. All you guys do, all you pussies do is complain about the man and the drug companies and all that. Who do you think got AIDS under control, huh? Who, your hippie buddies? Your protesters? The ones who are making the quilt? Or the man? Or the man? The man did it. Do you understand? So start kissing the man's ass. Because he cured your buddies, you pussies. Please.
When I was in training.
So convenient.
When I was in training, somebody
came
in for...
Why can't they do more? They're charging to you. The man cured your ass with AIDS.
When I was in training, people would come with their first episode of pneumocystis, and we would say, you have 6 months to live. Period.
That was AIDS.
And now they come in, we say, hey, you have a chronic illness.
That's right.
We'll deal with it, no problem.
That's right. And who came up with that?
The man.
Some guy out of a VW van wearing Birkenstocks who didn't want to harm the earth, or the man? Yeah, who made AZT, Drew? Who made those triple cocktails? Who did all that stuff?
The man.
The man.
It's like church in here.
Kiss the man's ass. Or do me a favor. Don't use it. Uh-huh. Yeah. Now, you know, you got something real? Yeah, go to Canada over there and don't use anything. Live off the... Start eating raw food. Eat raw food. That's going to cure your AIDS. Yeah, go eat it. Or shut up. Pussies. Tired of these guys. And as soon as they get now, it's right back to beating up on the man again. It's how the man works. Man don't care about AIDS. He don't care about you. He don't care gay or straight. Man wants money. That's it. He goes out, and here's the thing. He spends a bunch of money on R&D, burn a few lab rats. You do this, you rape a little rainforest, and now you got to get compensated. That's how the man works. It's a business. He doesn't know you. He doesn't know your friends. He doesn't care if you got it because you're hemophiliac or because you're manning a glory hole. Well, he doesn't care. Well, he wants his money. But
he may put his focus on things for altruistic reasons, but ultimately.
Ultimately. He wants money.
His focus may be to help people.
And let me say this, too.
Ultimately, he wants...
Let me say this, too, Lefty Puss. Pay the man because you don't want him to shut his lab down because the next time one of these comes around, the man needs to have his lab because your pussy buddies ain't going to cure anything. That's the point. Give the man his money. He can buy a new lab, get a couple of Bunsen burners, and next thing you know, we're in good shape when the next version of AIDS comes around. Oh, and it's coming. God
has a plan.
God has a plan.
Yeah.
That's right. That's all right. We're righteous. We will.
Amen.
We will survive. Yeah. And I'm talking about just the four people in this room. Sorry, Michelle. And it's up to us to repopulate. Wait a minute. You're back in. That's right.
Change plans. Change plans.
And we're going by height. All right. Harold and Kumar go to White Castle. Everybody. Yeah, the man doesn't want you to see it, but you're going to see it anyway. Out on DVD, we'll take a quick break. We'll be right back after this.